malaria, Ebola, Zika, Lassa fever, yellow fever, and now COVID-19. Mankind has been fighting microorganisms for thousands of years, and they've always won, and they are still winning.
COVID exposed to the general public what people in infectious diseases have known for a really long time. We don't have a system to detect emergent threats.
By the time we have details on a new outbreak, it's usually too late to contain it. But we can change that. Sentinel is an early warning system that relies on CRISPR technology and frontline healthcare workers to detect emerging diseases before they start a pandemic.
These viruses have been hunting us for millennia, and now we have the tools and technologies to identify them and stop them as soon as they emerge.
I think it is high time to play offense instead of continuing to play defense. I'm Christian Happy, Director of the Africa Center of Excellence for Genomics of Infectious Diseases.
I'm Dr. Pardeep Sabetti. I'm a computational biologist at the Broad Institute of MIT and Harvard.
Pardeep and Christian have been working together for over 20 years to combat the spread of viruses worldwide.
We started becoming really aware that so many of these infectious diseases were just going undetected. It started with just training a few of our lab staff and having a back and forth between the US and Africa and creating a network. We were just launching that when Ebola hit.
For weeks now, an outbreak of highly contagious Ebola virus has gripped Guinea.
And what we did then was train people across the region on how to diagnose the disease.
And we were poised in positions in our field sites in Sierra Leone and in Nigeria to set up diagnostics right away. And as a result, the teams in both of those countries diagnosed the first cases of Ebola in those countries.
Nigeria had to act fast, and the number of Ebola deaths was limited to 8.
That is incredible. For an outbreak that happened in a city like Lagos, with more than 20 million people.
Their successful work in disease outbreaks led Christian and Pardeep to develop Sentinel, a comprehensive program designed to detect emerging viruses before they spread and stop them in their tracks. Part of Sentinel is a new generation of sensitive and affordable tests. One of them is called Sherlock.
Sherlock is a technology that we're using for diagnosis that is based on CRISPR. And CRISPR was originally identified as a bacteria's immune system to viruses. And in Sherlock, we've been using that CRISPR technology to detect viruses.
Essentially, CRISPR molecules are programmed to detect specific viruses in human fluid samples. If the test cannot identify a virus, it's likely something humans haven't seen before. In that case, genomic sequencing can be used to identify the new virus and create new Sherlock tests within 24 hours.
It essentially leads to field-deployable, cheap, sensitive, rapidly programmable diagnostics. And that's what you need to move quickly in responding to infectious disease.
Creating a rapid testing system for outbreaks is essential, but it's only useful if you have a lot of people using it on the ground.
You can't address pandemic only with tools and technologies. You need people. And those people, they are the community health workers. Over the past 5 years, we've trained over 1,000 healthcare workers in West Africa to detect known and unknown pathogens, connect this information directly to the public health authorities, and then facilitate what we call a coordination of response at country level, and then at continental level, and at global level.
Part of that coordinated approach is creating apps that community health workers can use to share the data they collect with local and national public health officials. With COVID-19, developers are getting an opportunity to road test their products.
We were going to work on this project over the course of 5 years, thinking about infectious disease in general. But then when the COVID-19 pandemic hit, we've been focusing on how do we quickly prototype and get initial versions out of the applications we've been envisioning so that we could use them in COVID-19 response. Fathom is working on Scout and Lookout, which are part of the broader Sentinel project. Scout is for individual users to be able to track their symptoms daily, as well as keep track of their contacts. And the other application is Lookout, which is the desktop dashboard where the administrators can kind of keep track of everything that's going on.
I can tell you that since March, my lab has been doing only COVID. We are testing for the country. We're also doing the sequencing to guide public health response. We are working in very close collaboration with the state government, with the federal government, through the Nigeria Center for Disease Control.
I think really this is the biggest benefit that Sentinel provides, is that it pulls together science and public health into collaborations that will hopefully make the world a safer place to live in.
The most important challenge that we have as a continent is the ability to manage information and knowledge. We are a continent of 1.2 billion people. The tendency is to see a lot of fragmentation. Africa CDC can work with Sentinel to really scale that up and promote it across the continent.
Today, we've realized that the world is such a global village. It takes 36 hours for a disease that started in a small place in Nigeria to get to San Francisco or New York. So it means that we are so interconnected. We need to really sit down and then think about how we can create a world that is more equitable, where there is equity, where people understand that regardless of where you are, you can access medicine, you can access drugs, you can access vaccine, you can access diagnostics. That's the driving force behind what we're doing.
It sounds like a really big idea. It was a very small idea when we started. The approach to it is not that I'm going to change the world. It's actually just looking at a problem, finding a partner that you'd want to work with on that problem, and it's actually something very small. It's something very intimate. Every part of this, we must do better. We should never be in a situation again in which we have to stop the world to stop a pandemic. So for me, it's getting us to that better place that we've now got the world's attention, and it's on us to take this moment and not let it slip through our fingers.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, consider sharing it. Be sure to check out our website, freethink.com, for more stories of people moving the world.